the most 90s sitcom walk you could have, but it's like this. With your button down, like hanging off your shoulders.
I'm looking so like, help, I don't know where I am.
This is like truly Kevin Richardson face. Is that his name from Backstreet Boys? And why do I, am I saying his full first and last name?
Lauren and I have been known each other, been performing together since I moved to California, but we also have been talking about TV a lot, and then I thought that, oh no, you listened to the episode of High and Mighty, and we're like, I can come on and talk about TV.
Oh yes, okay, so Gabrus has a podcast called High and Mighty, and he has people on who talk about whatever interests them, and then he had people on talking about TV, and I was like, I have to chime in, this is like driving me insane that I can't add.
And you were in England, and you were like, when I get back to America, can we do this? I was like, of course I would.
So we did the episode, and it was so fun, and we were kind of like, we could have talked for so much longer about like 80s and 90s TV that we were like, we should just have our own podcast, but that's all we talk about. And so we did. We cover pretty much everything we can remember from that period of time that was on TV or around it.
So we've talked a lot about snacks.
Yeah. A lot of snacks, a lot of commercials, a lot of game shows.
Weird toys.
Toys, cartoons. I mean, just like everything that we were exposed to, I think, at that point in our lives is fair game.
Yeah, for the first episode, we just didn't have any ideas of what we were going to talk about, and we just talked about whatever came in our mind and had our producer, Josh, write down everything that, like, we were just like, that's a good idea for an episode, and he wrote it down, and then we have like 12 episode ideas. Yeah, and we were like, brought it to Earwolf, and we're like, is this a cool idea? They were like, yeah,
let's do it.
Yeah. If it's you too, yeah, we'll make more money off you in some capacity. It sounds great. Yeah. So it's been really fun, and I guess we haven't ever hung out this much.
It's been really cool. It's been very cool, like, getting to be friends through this. We have so many shared memories, like, even though we didn't know each other,
we have
the same base of like,
we're so different, yet so similar. It's almost like we should remind everyone in America we're more alike than we thought.
I personally loved the commercials episode we did because I didn't think that we could possibly have that much to say about it.
It was crazy how it ended, and we were like, wait, we're not done.
I was like, I have more to say.
And to do something called Commercials Part 2 just sounds like insanely self-indulgent.
It is, but I mean, I feel like there's going to be people who relate to this. Because that was what's so exciting about, like, finding out that you knew all the same stuff I did. That I was like, oh, I didn't have any friends who really had the same exact, like, obsession with TV.
Also, she's not saying it, but the reason Lauren really liked the commercials episode was because we sang like 100 jingles, and that's right in your wheelhouse.
That's so true. That is why I loved it. I love jingles and theme songs.
I mean, you went apeshit when we put on the Tiny Toons theme song, and both of us just kind of like eyes rolled back in our head,
like,
and
we're
knew all the. We're all
alone,
and we're like, in this cartoony, we're in your TV. And we were just like, and we kept knowing all the lines, and we were like, and it was like one of those things where I felt like Neo, because I didn't know I knew
we
it.
We didn't
and
know. It was, and I it was just really, like, that one was like very deep for me, but I was like, it's all there. I just can't look at you.
Activated something. I remembered my mother's social security number in that moment. I have a lot of repressed memories from something terrible that happened to me while Tiny Toons was on.
I'm sure we both do, and that's why we're like, I love this show.
This show is so great. It's louder than mom and dad fighting. Yeah, also, I would say that the podcast ends up being a springboard for us talking about our childhoods a lot.
Yeah, too. And just like memories we've kind of pushed back.
One of my favorite moments from the podcast was we were talking about snacks, and then we started talking about chocolate milk, and we both got so excited. We said in unison, yes, it was the best. You used to be able to make it. And she said,
I said Hershey's.
And I said Bosco at the same time, and it just completely established our dynamic.
It was so funny.
That we were so similar, but I was just slightly more poor and white trash. Yeah.